What is cracking, everybody? You are back with Mr. Berger, and if you know me, you know that I like to play WoW. Now, WoW is one of those games that came out about 15 years ago at this point, and I've been playing it basically since the year that it launched. On and off, obviously, not consistently. So this is one of my most OG old school games. They re-released Classic a few months back, and I haven't had much time, but I figured now that I got a little bit of time, do this extra time off, I would do a little bit of a character showcase on a couple of my characters. So today we're going to be looking at my Paladin. She's a Ret Paladin in Classic WoW. So let's go ahead and turn on the interface here. A few things first of all, I'm playing on Bloodsail Buccaneers. It's the only RP server that's not a PvP RP server. Let's go ahead and get going on down here to some questing area, or to a questing area. Well, I continue talking, show you guys kind of how you got on up here to this cool spot. So I'm playing on that realm. It's unfortunately it's a East Coast realm, so I do get a slight increase in lag, but it works out just fine. Alternatively, I have a 60 Warlock as of a few days ago on Paggle, which is another US East realm. But it was kind of one of these things where my buddy said, "Hey, we're gonna play on this realm, so make your alliance characters there." So that's what I did. My girlfriend has also got one in that realm with me, and she recently hit 60 as well, so those are our highest level characters in Classic. If you know me, as I mentioned earlier, you know that I've been playing WoW a lot, or for many years. So back in the day, back in like Warlords of Draenor, I had like some like 15 plus max level characters. I've played on and off throughout various expansions. I played Vanilla, BC, Wrath of the Lich King, I skipped Pandaria. I came partway through Warlords of Draenor, played a little bit of Legion. Oh yeah, Cataclysm. Played a little bit of Cataclysm back there. I forgot about that one. And then I stopped, I think, in Legion. And I haven't played the most recent one, Battle for Azeroth. But then the Classic version came out. And I decided, okay, let's go ahead and hop on that. It's been a lot of fun. Classic is really interesting because it's a lot slower paced, you know? You don't get your mounts at 40, you're walking around a lot. There's a lot more world walking, but there's a lot more interaction. It's pretty cool, it's a lot more social. In vanilla, you're generally just, in retail, you're generally just like, you know, rushing, flying around everywhere, trying to get stuff as fast as you can. You get your mount at level 1 because of the heirloom mount, you've got all these heirlooms, you level up super fast. You do like 3 quests in a zone and suddenly you finish that zone, you know what I mean? This is a lot more slow paced than I really enjoy. Lastly, before I forget about realms, we have our main characters on White Main, or at least that was where we started our main characters. It is a PvP realm, we're playing Horde there, me and my buddies, and they've continued on there. But I kind of didn't like PvP realms as much as I did back in the day, because I don't worry too much about PvPing, and it's more about like, if you're questing, you have the option to get ganked if you're on a PvP realm, and that's generally how PvP goes. Yeah, occasionally you'll have some fun battles while you're leveling against people in the other of a similar level, but sometimes you just want to relax and quest and take your time, and that's what this character is all about, is taking it slow, just doing a ton of damage, taking the time to sit back and regain my mana when necessary for, you know, a trade-off of doing more damage. Rather than, you know, consistently being able to fight and keeping my mana up. And I'll explain a little bit more about that when I go to the talents here. But that's basically what's happening here. So, again, before I forget, the PvE, PvP realms, you can always do battlegrounds either way. So even if you are playing on a PvE realm like I'm doing here, you still have the option to PvP. And that's mostly where I would do most of my PvP back in the day and up until recently. Anyways, generally in battlegrounds. So, I'm not too worried about it. Takes away the option of getting ganked, so it's a little bit more relaxing and enjoyable for me. This character is one that I made because I wanted to try an RP role for the first time. Not a lot of people RP, honestly. Some people do, but not a whole ton of them. A lot of people just kind of play it like a normal role. And that's not a big deal, but generally people are a little bit lonelier. Downsides to this realm, as I mentioned, it's a US East server, so it's a little bit laggier. And also, since it's not super populated, there's not too many people on all the time. Oh, gotta buff myself. Forgot. Sorry, guys. There's not too many people on all the time, so sometimes it's hard to get a group. The economy isn't as good, but when I play on, like, Paggle, you go to, like, Ironforge, and it's just absolutely packed. You can sell stuff for a lot of gold, and consistently. So I enjoy that, but I also just kind of want to try the RP thing, and so I decided to stick with this character, and I'm having a lot of fun. You can see it's a very, very straightforward, simple rotation. Pretty much just use Seal of the Crusader, and then Judgment them to get the increased holy damage, and then use Seal of Commands, and that's pretty much it. You just auto-attack them from there, and spam Judgment. So, let's really quickly, before we go into more depth about like the skills and rotation, let's take a look at my talents and how I'm doing this build. So, I went full Retribution, and I went full, like, single target damage, basically. A lot of people will go Holy, put, you know, 5 points in there, maybe 5 points in there, and then get Consecration for some AoE damage. But I just went straight down Retribution, because I like the idea of just doing a ton of single target damage. And then, you know, when I'm playing this game, oftentimes it's kind of slow-paced, casually. I'm watching Hulu or Netflix in the background, so I don't mind, you know, taking it slow and waiting for my mana to regain every couple minutes or bringing water to drink for a trade-off of doing that maximum amount of damage. So I got Improved Blessing of Might to make me do more damage, right? Rather than the reduced mana cost to keep me in combat for longer and keep my mana up for fights. Since I'm not doing a whole lot of dungeons, it's not a big deal to keep that mana up. As I said, you can just take the downtime in between fights. Or alternatively, make sure you bring a lot of water to your dungeon and you'll be able to keep your mana up that way. This one, the reason that you get Improved Seal of the Crusader, well, you don't really need the parry chance. You can get that for defense, but remember, this is a full damage build. Improved Seal of the Crusader basically makes it so that your melee attack power is increased, but also the holy damage of the Seal of the Judgment is increased. So you use Seal of the Crusader, and then you Judgment them, and it puts a debuff on them that increases the holy damage that they take. And you deal a ton of holy damage as Retribution Paladin. So that's why you want that one there. And you'll see instances of the holy damage as we go along to this, to the rest of the talents and the skills and the rotation here. This one's very straightforward, decreases the cooldown of Judgment Spell by 2 seconds. If you like the parry chance, that's more of a tank skill, it's more of a prop pally skill. But if you're solo questing and you're just trying to stay in combat and stay alive, it's not bad. I just went for the straight damage. The reason that I chose this one, normally I wouldn't get this, but ultimately, it reduces the target's agility, which in turn reduces their armor, which in turn gives me more damage. So I'm just going straight on full damage. This is very straightforward, increases crit chance, Seal of Command for single target damage, Pursuit of Justice, don't need to explain that one, it's just great for leveling. Increases move speed. I didn't worry about this, because this is more of a, it does increase damage, but it doesn't increase my, like, single target straightforward auto attack damage. It's more of like, if I'm taking hits, then it returns some damage, which isn't what I'm going for with this build. Improved Retribution Aura, since I got Sanctity Aura, I didn't bother with that one. Sanctity Aura, increasing my holy damage. Very straightforward here with the two-handed weapon specialization, just increases melee weapon damage. Straightforward, just damage increase to your melee auto attacks. This one's pretty cool. Basically, when you crit, you get even more physical and holy damage. So you can see the trend here. We're going for straight physical and holy damage. Just right off the bat, smacking stuff, slow weapon attack speed, two-hander, dealing a ton of damage all at once, watching their health bar melt, cut in half in one hit or in one global. It's pretty great. Repentance, well, not super necessary, but I like it. It's good. It's a little bit of crowd control. Why not have it? And it's at the very bottom. It can come in handy. On top of that, it incapacitates them. And if you read the Seal of Command, if you read the actual... Am I blocking it here? No, okay, good. Perfect. If you read the actual Judgment's effect, it does more damage if the target is stunned or incapacitated. So you can stun them with your Hammer of Justice, or now you can incapacitate them with Repentance temporarily, just to get that increased Judgment damage. And let me tell you guys, Judgment is probably my heaviest hitter right now. When I have, obviously Sanctity Aura is always going to be up, Blessing of Might does the damage increase, although I don't think that increases my holy damage, but you've got all your holy damage plus this thing right here, the Vengeance procs, gives you a 15% increase, and then you Repent or Hammer of Justice them to stun or incapacitate them, and then you Judgment them, then it hits so hard when it crits. You don't always get a crit, but occasionally you'll get that super hard crit. What I'm going to do now, you'll notice I'm only 41, but what I plan to do now is basically go into Holy, get the increased Strength for straight more damage, get the increased Intellect just to dump points into that, and on top of that, Intellect does come in handy for a Retribution Paladin. Increases your mana points and chance to score a critical hit with spells, which increases the chance to crit with things like my Judgment, And if I'm occasionally using Exorcism on undead targets, that'll increase that crit chance as well. So that's, I mean, the rate at which weapon skills improve, not really necessary, but you get the idea. It's mostly for that mana pool and for that increased crit chance with spells. And then you get Consecration just so I have a little bit of AoE. And from there, I haven't really decided. There's a lot of different ways you can go. Now, alternatively, a lot of people like to get Benediction to increase their mana pool. As I mentioned, some people get Deflection for the parry chance just to keep them more defensive. Not a lot of people get Vindication, but I tried to go with it this time. You know, there's a lot of different ways to do it. A lot of people will go wholly into Consecration early on and then go Retribution if you're going for more AoE damage. And then basically you'll be using Seal of Righteousness for a while until you get Seal of Crusader. And that's not bad. Then you can do like a Retribution aura build and things like that. It's a lot of fun in Classic. A lot of different things that we can do. So I think that's mostly what I wanted to cover, other than the rotation, which we're going to get into in a minute here. So we did Realms, we did Talents. I do have another character I want to showcase in another video, but let's go ahead and get to a little bit of combat and rotation here. So a lot of the Paladin skills are the different seals, and you don't use the different seals and blessings a lot. Like, for example, Blessing of Salvation. Yeah, that takes up one of my learned skills and one of my slots on my taskbar. That's great, but I don't use it a whole lot unless I'm in a group. Like, I'm not going to be using that reduced threat questing alone. Seal of Justice, that's one that's pretty decent because it prevents them from running. That's kind of like a little extra one. Seal of Light, like, okay, that's cool, but in Classic, since there's no, like, specifications for what class or what spec you're going, every spec gets a general amount of spells. Paladin, since they can be healer, DPS, or a tank, then they have all these different spells that would fulfill those different roles. So if you're fulfilling only one of those roles, you've still got, for example, I'm fulfilling DPS role, I've still got all my tank and all my healing skills, other than, you know, a few talents that I might get down the talent tree. So, like, things like that, you know, that one's more of a tanking skill because it heals you. Purify, very useful, but generally more of a healer skill. But don't get me wrong, that's not the best example. That's pretty core in soloing as well, because you want to be able to debuff yourself. But look at this, we've got 7 different auras. I got Frost Resist Aura, Shadow Resist Aura, and Fire Resist Aura. Concentration Aura, Retribution, Devotion. I mostly only use like these 2 or 3. On very rare occasion, I'll go ahead and use, you know, one of the resistance auras. It is kind of cool. I did do a dungeon run the other day with 4 paladins. So we had Tank Paladin, Healer Paladin, 2 DPS Paladins, and a Mage for water. And we had like all the different auras up. So like I had Sanctity, the Tank had Devotion or Retribution, somebody else had Devotion, and then the Healer had one of the resistance auras up, depending on like what the fight was or you know, what dungeon we were in, or so on and so forth. So there's those extremities, you know, Blessing of Light, for example, you don't use a lot. And then you've got, like, all your bubbles. You got 3 different bubbles and Lay on Hands. And those are all kind of like, oh crap, buttons to save yourself. You got your Resurrection. But again, these are, like, all taking up skill slots that, like, on my Warlock, it's like, oh, I've got another curse that does, I got the curse that does damage. I got, like, 4 dots. I've got multiple damage spells, all these different things, you know, fears, stuns. On the Paladin, it's more like, oh, look, I got another healing skill that I'm going to use once every couple hours or something. You know what I mean? So it's a little bit, what I'm getting at here is it's a little bit more kind of straightforward and boring when it comes to your rotation because of that. So let's go ahead and skip all the extremities. I don't need to get into more detail with that. And let's go into most of my core things. I always keep myself buffed with Blessing of Might because we have that improved Blessing of Might. Generally, you run up, you have Seal of the Crusader up, you Judgment them to put the debuff on, then you Seal of Command, and then you just Judgment upon cooldown. And you want to use your Hammer of Justice to increase the judgment damage. I will often save it against humanoid targets for when they're running away as well. You can also do the Repentance now. I used to do that, so I don't think I have been using that more. If you start dying, you can heal yourself with Holy Light or Flash of Light in a more dire situation. You can always toss Lay on Hands on yourself. Don't be afraid to use that. Yeah, it's a 1-hour cooldown, but if you never use it, you never use it. And that's a really great one. Uses all your mana, but it also gives you 250 mana back, and it heals you to full. And you've, of course, you got your 3 different bubbles for different situations. Exorcism, I have it there for when I'm going against undead targets or demons, like, you know, these guys right here, because it does work, yeah, it does work against demons. Or these ladies right here, sorry, it's a succubus. And what else? We got the stun, we got Seal of Justice to keep them from running away, which I use occasionally, but I'll often just go for the straight damage. I've got Blessing of Wisdom there, and occasionally I'll switch from Sanctity Aura to Devotion Aura, put Blessing of Wisdom up, toss Seal of Wisdom off, and just auto-attack things for a little bit, and I can take a lot of damage because of the improved armor, and I'll put the Judgment of Wisdom and the Seal of Wisdom up, you know, Judgment on them and Seal on me, and I'll be regaining mana, essentially, and I'll be able to heal myself. And so it's kind of like a cheap way to keep fighting really slowly, but keep up your mana and get back into the fight without having to take downtime to drink or whatever. But for the most part, for straight damage, I'm going to Sanctity Aura, Blessing of Might, charging. And what was the last one? I think that's it, right? Oh, the Judgment, sorry, and the Seal, which we will start right here. So comment all you want on my layout. There's a lot of different ways to lay things out in this game. You know, a lot of different ways to do different action bars. So if you have your way of doing it and you'd like to let me know down below, please feel free to comment. Let me know what you guys like to do. Do you not like to use shift keys? One of my buddies would not stop giving me crap because I know that, like, you can hold right click and use A and D to strafe, but over the years I've been so used to using Q and E as well to strafe in different ways, like when you're not holding right click, for example, or to be running forward and, you know, just be have different options there. Got the muscle memory down. A lot of people will rebind Q and E though, so if you do that, that's probably great. I'm just so used to this way that I decided not to change it. I use most of my core skills here. You can see like 2, 3, 4, 5, TYV, G is there, R is there, F is right in between. I keep most of my core skills kind of in this general area. And then more extra stuff, you know, shift 1, shift 2, all those things right there. The shifts and the controls are way over here. I rarely use controls, but I like to have them as backups. So you'll see I put things like redemption, like my res on control T. Like I'm almost never going to use that, but it's good to have it there. Some of them are useful, like Control-Z is actually really easy to hit, because Control and Z are really close to each other, you can just move your fingers down. So on the rare occasion that I want to turn an undead, I have that option and I can hit that hotkey. So some like Lay on Hands, very occasionally I know that's Control-4. Oftentimes I'll just go down and click it, but sometimes I'll be like, oh yeah, Control-3, that's kind of like my oh crap button, or Control-4. So it works out, but for the most part I'm using just like T, Y, V, F, G, R, 1 through 6. Very occasionally, I have 7 there. I don't usually use 7, but I just kind of slapped it down there because it's right next to the other heal. And let's see, you can see more of my bindings there. There's Z, which I started using recently. R is really useful. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Let's go ahead and kill a few things here, and let's wrap this video on up. Oh, we're already at like 18 minutes. I talk a lot. Alright, let's get a good spot to kill some stuff. There's some other people running around here. So he's going to aggro that one. We can help him out. And so you can put the Judgment to increase the damage. And then you can kill them and exorcism them if it's an undead or demon target. And it'll do a ton of damage. Actually, I need that swashbuckler over there. So let's go get him. So we're going to start with Seal of Crusader. We run in and do Judgment of Crusader. Then we just instantly do Seal of Command. Seal of Command and Judgment. I think the Judgment is not on the global cooldown or something like that. Yeah, because you can see I use Judgment and it doesn't reset the global cooldown. But then when I use the Seal, everything else does. Now he's getting, let's repent him. And then let's go ahead and use the Judgment to increase the damage. He's getting a little low, so when he runs, I save my stun. Because humanoids are pretty much always run. My stun is going to run away. Increase damage with the Judgment. And it finishes him off. Alright, what I would like to do is show you guys really quickly the alternative that I do for gaining mana. But it's generally more effective against like a melee target. I don't really want to go against these guys with the pets. And there's a lot right there, so I feel like if I run in, I'm going to aggro them all. So let's just run along here. And let's see if we can't find like a melee target. Another swashbuckler that's kind of by himself. At this point, I could kill that thing, but I don't really need it. So let's run along here. This is classic. You're doing all this running around. Classic. Alright, well, they've probably killed most of them at this point. So let's just, I just want to show you guys this example on the crab. So like, I switched to Devotion Aura, put Seal of Wisdom up, put Blessing of Wisdom up. I put the Judgment of Wisdom on him, and then I refresh the Wisdom. Those both will get me mana. The debuff has a chance to restore mana, and the buff on me has a separate chance to restore mana. And then basically you just sit back and watch. See, I'm basically regaining mana, and it's boring, like I'm just auto-attacking, but if you're sitting here and you're watching Netflix, or you're playing another game, or whatever you might be doing, you're eating your lunch, whatever, it's a good class for that. And my mana is almost near full, and I can just toss a quick heal on myself. It's gonna be a little bit overkill here, but then I'll take that extra time to regain mana. And here we go. Oh, somebody buffed. Let's buff her back.
Thank you.
There we go. Awesome. So I use a little bit more mana because I like buffed her and rebuffed myself and things like that. But you get the idea. Alright guys, that is pretty much it for my showcase of my Paladin Tiana on Bloodsail Buccaneers. It's an RP PvE realm that I've really been I plan to do a little bit more WoW videos when I find time here and there. You know, it kind of just depends on how things go. I hope that you guys are all holding tight and hanging tight and doing well in all this craziness. Thank you so much for watching and have a good night.